another didge for Mazzy. Have you seen a didgeridoo before, Mazzy? This instrument? You have? Do you know how they get hollowed out like that? Okay, so it's because little termites, white ants, get in. And I learned from Aboriginal people how to go looking for didgeridoos. So you find trees like this, and you hit it with a stick, and you can actually hear that it's hollow. Do you want to put your ear against that? And I'll tap it, and you can hear that it's hollow inside. And this instrument's been around, some people say, for about 100,000 years. So basically how you make a sound from the didgeridoo, and some of you fellas can have a go later if you like, is basically by going. Keeping the vibration going with your lips. And so it's a little bit trickier than that. I sing and play guitar. That's another hat that I wear. I work as a professional singer. And playing guitar and singing didn't come that naturally to me. I had lots of passion. But didgeridoo, as soon as I picked it up, I remember I was hanging with an Aboriginal family that had a didgeridoo in their house when I was about 5. And as soon as I picked it up, I went...
Nice.
Beautiful instrument, isn't it? This one's made of iron bark, so it's really, really heavy wood. So if I'm ever leaving a gig in a dangerous place, get yourself out of trouble. It nearly happened once, I'll tell you that story later. Trying to get a ride, and no one will pick the poor fella up. He looks a bit rough around the edges, old hat, and hasn't shaved for a while. And so a few cars go past. He then sees a kangaroo jumping over the highway, followed by little Joey. Following its mum over the highway. He nearly gets hit by a truck, toot toot! And in the end he finds a motorbike at the side of the road. He doesn't steal it, he borrows it, gives it back the next day, and takes off down the highway on the motorbike, sticking to the speed limit of course. See if you can hear all that in this song, The Hitchhiker. Get off the road, mate! For your breathing, get your lungs going, feel like you need to have a lie down.
So you picked up at 5, you could play it. How easily did the circular breathing come to you?
Oh, the circular breathing, so I forgot to mention that. And when I said I played like that, I got a bit carried away. I didn't play like that when I was 5. I made the sound of it, so I went... And they went, oh, that's cool, you can do it. And I'm like, yeah. And with the circular breathing, I'll show you how to circular breathe if you like.
Yeah.
Crunch your tick. That's how to circular breathing.
Wow.
People say to practice through a straw. That works for some people. Sometimes it takes some years to get it. You can fill your cheeks with water. That's circular breathing.
Wow.
Handy thing to be able to do. Then I want to give it a try.
Yeah. Fuck yeah.
Away from old mate, is someone going to give it a try?
Pubbers just did. Yeah,
how'd you go?
Just the first one.
Now you have pneumonia.
So step one. Get the drone and you quite literally. Step two, fill your cheeks up and just let it come out naturally. Step three, separate the two. And then step, and what's that?
Four.
Step four, thank you. The clutch and the accelerator, the changeover, and that's just letting the air out of your cheeks and sucking in through your nose. A little hint to get a good rhythm going, you can actually say the word didgeridoo. And then use the circular breathing as your rhythm. Here we go. So. This is one of the highest forms of antioxidants found in nature. So I remember eating this about 10 years ago for a few weeks, and I didn't change my diet. My diet wasn't great at the time, and I was not as fit and as healthy as I could be, so I didn't do anything else except for eat a handful of these fruit every day for I think it was 5 or 6 weeks. And everyone kept coming up going, Jake, you look younger, you look really healthy, what have you done? You've been working out, you've been doing so. I said, nah, and I've just been hooking into these. So antioxidants are incredibly important. Late in the afternoon, you cut them into sections about that long and blow through it. Fresh water pours out a good amount, about 50% of the time. It makes you waterproof for a couple of hours. You can't get in and done layers of it and able to walk around in the rain for a couple of hours without getting wet. But here I've got chickweed. Or spilaria. It's an introduced species and it's absolutely everywhere. Great for urinary tract infections. Very, very handy to know. And just a good green leafy vegetable that's full of vitamins and minerals. Not to be mistaken for anyone that's taking notes, not to be mistaken for milkweed or cancer weed. Called cancer weed because the milky sap from this is currently being used to treat skin cancer in its early stages and really effectively. Some doctors are starting to say to people, go and get some milkweed. Go and get some milkweed, euphorbia I think the botanical name is, and put that on your skin cancer.